finally, can you please pick up your sword and describe the course?
So this is a long sword. It's the primary sword that we use for two levels at point. While the entire item is a weapon and can be used defensively, we primarily attack with the point and the blade and come to the pommel when appropriate. The grip is made up of the cross, the grip, and the pommel. There are two key points to our application of the arc. First being the center of percussion, so if you're straight the sword at the base, there's a quiet point about a third of the way down the blade. This is where we want to be engaging our opponents for the best possible engagement. To move north at that point is to move on to the width of the sword, where you increasingly risk your parry failing, so you have more flexibility. And to move south of there, to move on to the strong, where there's more security but also less flexibility. The second point is the center balance, located a few fingers past the cross. Around this point, we want to make all of our attacks, moving the center of balance in a straight line between where it is and where we'd like our attack to culminate. Moving ourselves to allow the sword to unwind around it and complete the motion of the cut. Additionally, not a property of the sword, but of how we hold it, we have a true and false edge. Towards the knuckles of the right hand, we have a true edge, and on the other side, we have a true false.
Very nice. Okay.
The mission of AEMMA is to resurrect, research, study, practice, and instruct the combative skills, principles, and philosophies of an accomplished European medieval martial artist, and to achieve a state that is consistent with that of a medieval martial artist, both in technology and ideal.
Which of the attributes would you consider the most important?
Fiore tells us that Alanesia is the most important,
and overall armament of the breed. When you come here, there's the willingness to do this, the rest of it all.
Last call. All right. So we will move.